The Dark Knight's Joker as Nietzsche Supermensch on this episode of The Sci-Fi Show. The second Christopher Nolan Batman movie, The Dark Knight, regarded as the best of the three by many, has Heath Ledger in one of his last performances taking on the role of the clown prince of crime, the Joker. The Joker, a violent sociopath that knows no boundaries, who will kill on a whim and seems, in the words of Alfred, to just want to watch the world burn. A man who murders allies and enemies with equal abandon and fears nothing, who pursues whatever anarchic vision he wishes without regard to the lives he damages or destroys. To contrast this dangerous lunatic, we have a late 19th century philosopher, who is by all accounts a largely peaceful man, with a compassion for animals, a man whose last act in life before a breakdown and descent into madness was to defend a horse from an owner who was savagely whipping it. This man was the philosopher Friedrich Nietzsche. What could these two possibly have in common? Nietzsche is a philosopher who has cast a long shadow over the 20th century, who is an inspiration for communists, Nazis, vegetarians, anarchists, and many others. His big idea centered around how to reinvent and rebuild society now that, in the words of a mad prophet in his book, The Gay Science, we had killed God. Nietzsche saw that after such an act, man would need to rebuild anew his foundations for the social order, and that the attempts by the 19th century to limp along on the last vestiges of Christian morality could not last now that the reason for that moral framework had been abandoned. He spoke of transvaluing values and moving beyond good and evil. Nietzsche also spoke of the idea of the will to power and his conception of the Übermensch that would be its greatest proponent. It should be noted that the term Übermensch is a German word that is translated into English as Superman or Overman, and was adopted with relish by the Nazis as a depiction of their soldiers. I suspect Nietzsche would not have been impressed with the way the Nazis ran with his ideology, but at the same time, I don't think they particularly perverted it either, as some have claimed. Nietzsche had a concept of what he termed slave morality, by which he meant the ancient Christian moral framework that had informed Western civilization for centuries, and he saw this morality as something no longer binding on us, that we needed to grow up and move beyond this. So what is the will to power and who is the Übermensch? Perhaps that's the wrong place to start, as these are the ideas that Nietzsche is left with after the death of God, which he so memorably described by his lantern-wielding madman who proclaimed that God is dead and that we have murdered him, that we are now set adrift in the universe without the divine as an anchoring point, that churches have become God's tomb. Nietzsche saw in this a chance for liberation, but he also feared an abyss of nihilism that would flow from this deed. He did not mean that we had literally killed God, but that we had instead simply jettisoned the old idea and moved beyond it. Nietzsche understood that unmoored from the old theological foundation, we could not continue to borrow all of the features of it anymore. We would have to rebuild on a new, different foundation and start over. The will to power and the Übermensch was his vision for this reinvention of ourselves. If you remember back to the recent series on Thomas Aquinas, one of the possibilities for happiness that was tried was power. And when examined, we discovered that Thomas didn't just mean political power, but the ability and freedom to exercise your will as you see fit. This is the sort of power Nietzsche's talking about, the freedom and willingness to exercise your naked will to achieve whatever ends you set for yourself. The Übermensch is one strong enough to seize and exercise this will to power for themselves. Because of the death of God, there literally is nothing else to life, and the old shackles of the tablets of the law that defined right from wrong are broken and no longer restrain our actions. The strong assert their will as they please, and this is the new highest good according to Nietzsche. He proclaimed that we need to live beyond good and evil to do away with the old Christian herd morality. Strangely, he simply took the death of God for granted and never really offered much in the way of an argument for this position. It was simply assumed to be settled. Nietzsche did offer one thoroughly irrationalist argument in his book The Antichrist that went as follows. I will now disprove the existence of all gods. If there were gods, how could I bear not to be a god? Consequently, there are no gods. I don't know how convincing you find such an argument, but I'm a bit skeptical of its force. Still, it seems Nietzsche's task was less to provide an argument, but instead to work out the implications of this assumed atheism. Now that the news of the lantern-wielding madman had arrived, how do we live in this brave new world? So why is the Dark Knight's Joker the Übermensch? How could he not be? He does as he wills at every point in the movie, unless his will is thwarted by someone more powerful. There are no internal limits on his behaviour or his will. He simply kills and destroys as he wishes, in pursuit of whatever strange goals he has. He murders with absolute impunity, and when he encounters someone who threatens to stop him in the form of Batman, he targets those close to Batman and threatens to kill them without hesitation. All that matters to the Joker is his goals. Everything else is secondary to that. Perhaps the Joker is not ultimately an example of the Übermensch because he is thwarted by Batman, but that would suggest that the Joker's problem is he is not strongly willed enough to overcome his enemies. Given his willingness to blow up a passenger boat full of innocents, I'm not sure how much more beyond good and evil he could get, even if part of that was to show the citizens of Gotham that even their good and innocent people could be just as ruthless and murderous as him when their lives were on the line. As a slight digression, I did think that that was one of the most interesting scenes in a film filled with them. The two boatloads of people, one murderous convicts, the other a random collection of commuters, each told they must sacrifice the others if they are to live. Would they follow the Joker into the new will-to-power future and unflinchingly sacrifice others so that they may live? Or will they succumb to the old herd morality that values all life, even at the risk of the loss of their own? Would they be strong enough, in the Nietzschean sense, to do what was required? Or would they fail and fall back into the herd morality of Socrates that said it was better to suffer evil than to commit it? Need the will to power be this way, perfectly exemplified in the behaviour of a clown-faced homicidal maniac? I'm not sure how else it could be. I suppose you could will the good of your fellow man, and will their best and sacrifice your goals and wishes to their needs and desires if that's what you would will. But this sort of behaviour is the old slave morality, and besides, it would seem everyone who does behave in such a manner is a saint of the old sort. I'm not sure how the will to power could ever end up in a place different from something like the Joker, perhaps not quite so psychotic, and not so much wishing to simply watch the world burn, but it doesn't seem the creed of a hero, but only the creed of a villain. Now, unsurprisingly, I disagree with Nietzsche on just about every point. I'm a firm believer in the old Aristotelian and Thomistic vision of the universe that is ordered and ruled over by a benevolent creator, but I do have a great deal of respect for Nietzsche. He took his philosophy seriously and followed the implications where they may without regard for squeamishness. I'd fault him for not reaching the end and then not considering seriously that perhaps his premises are wrong, but at least he took the task before him seriously. Could you construct a version of the will to power that doesn't end in some sort of sociopathy or megalomania? Perhaps to ask the question like that is to start from the wrong place, because if that's all there is, the will to power, then you just have to take the universe the way you find it, and living without limits or constraints and actualizing your naked will as fully as possible isn't the behavior of a sociopath or a megalomaniac, but the actions of a supremely rational being. Now, you might want to be pretty sure that this is the case before you embark on such a course, but if will to power is all there is, then it seems honest to run with it, and the designation of megalomaniac or sociopath is just the misguided designation of the insufficiently enlightened. But let's consider the question anyway. Can you construct a psycho-free version of the will to power? Could you simply will to be kind and good to others, self-sacrificing and benevolent as your manifestation of the will to power? I'm not sure, but I don't think so. All the saints, and this is what this conception of the will to power would make you, do not ascribe to this sort of transvaluation of values. Nietzsche would seemingly reject it as slave morality, unfit for an Übermensch, and I think on this conception of things, he'd be right to do so. It seems it might be the same basic problem as the idea of utilitarian saints. It's just an idea that is irreconcilable with the basic idea of the will to power. What do you think? You can find more information on the different ideas contained in this episode in the show notes on scifishow.com. I can be reached with comments via feedback at scifishow.com, and you can leave a comment in the show notes at scifishow.com. You can also leave comments on the Facebook page, facebook.com/scifishow, and you can also follow the show via The Sci-Fi Show on Twitter. If you do enjoy the show, please go over to our Facebook page and click like. If there's a topic you'd like me to look into, please don't hesitate to ask. And don't forget, it's fine with a PH. Let me know what you think. show is released under a Creative Commons Attribution Non-Commercial Sharealike 3.0 license, and music is by Furious J and the Nightlight.
The Sci-Fi Show is a proud member of Noodle Mix Network. Find more of our award-winning and award-nominated podcasts to make you think, laugh, and succeed at noodle.mx. Learn how to podcast, theorize over the TV shows Once Upon a Time, Once Upon a Time in Wonderland, Marvel's Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., and Under the Dome. Laugh with our clean comedy, interface Christianity with the world, learn critical thinking from movie reviews, and more at noodle.mx.